Hello, I'm Carly McAvoy, talking about systems of equations, and the third method that people usually talk about in textbooks is they usually call the elimination method or the addition method. It varies from textbook to textbook. But the idea is this: if A equals B and C equals D, then A plus C equals B plus D. We can add this side of the equation and it should equal that side because both sides of the equations were equal to each other to begin with. So when you have a systems of equations to solve and you can quickly see that, hey, if I add these two together, I'm going to get these y's to eliminate, that's a great time to use the addition method, add them together, or the elimination method it's called because it eliminates something. So I'm going to do that right here. I'm going to add 2x plus 3x and get 5x. Negative y and positive y, well, those are gone. And 8 plus 2 is 10. And now dividing both sides by 5, I get x equals 2. If you add your equations together and nothing drops out, then you can't do it. You have to only add them together if something is going to be eliminated. Remember, though, our answer should be an ordered pair, and right now we have half of that, so we still have to go back and find the other one. You can plug into either one of these equations. I'm going to say 2 times 2 plus y equals 8. 2 times 2 is 4, so I'm subtracting 4 from both sides and get y equals 4. That's what I think my answer is. Let's do a quick check. If 2 times 2 is 4, and then I have plus 4, and that should equal 8. Yep. What about the second one? 2 times 2 is, or 3 times 2 is 6. Minus 4 is 2. That is also true. So I just put those values quickly back in to see if it equaled what was on the right-hand side, and it did. So there's the solution to my system. I used the addition method. In this particular problem, wow, I never wrote in what I wanted that to be. But I think I wanted it to be 9, so we'll make that a 9, see how that works out. If it doesn't work out, then so be it. You can see I changed, whited out here several times because I couldn't decide what to do. But anyway, let's do this. You can see the negative 3a and the positive 3a will cancel out, so I'm ready to add these two together. Negative 3a and positive 3a are gone. 3b and 4b is 7b. And 12 plus 9 is 21. Now I'm going to divide both sides by 7, and I'm going to get b equals 3. This is a and b, so my ordered pair is alphabetical a and then b. So I have the b is 3, and now I want to figure out what is a. So I can plug it back into either one of these. Negative 3a plus 3 times 3 is 12. So I have negative 3a plus 9 is 12. Subtract 9 from both sides. Negative 3a equals 3. And that means that we have a equals negative 1. So I have negative 1, 3. I can do a quick check here. Negative 3 times negative 1 is 3. 3 times 3 is 9. And that equals 12. Yep. Here, 3 times negative 1 would be negative 3. And 4 times 3 would be 12, and negative 3 and 12 equals 9, so yep, yep. So here's my solution, negative 1, 3, the answer to my system. All right, I want to show you number 3, because number 3 is not ready to add together. The other two we could add together right away and something would drop out. But in this one, that's not true. If I were to add together, I'd get 12x and 2y and negative 4. That doesn't help me. So what I'm going to do is multiply this bottom equation by 3. And if I do that, then I'm going to have positive 3y and negative 3y. So I'm always trying to get something to be opposites. I'm not changing the top equation, so I'm just going to rewrite that. But down here, I'm multiplying this whole thing by 3. 3 times 7 is 21x. 3 times negative y is negative 3y. And 3 times 2 is 6. Now, somebody is saying, what? How do you know to multiply by 3? That's the method I'm teaching you. So you wouldn't know it until I told you. But what I'm telling you is you need to make something be opposites. And so I could see here that I could make 3y and negative 3y, and those opposites would go away. So that's why I chose to multiply by 3 on the bottom, but I can't just multiply one term or else I throw my equation off. I had to multiply all three terms by 3. And now I'm ready to add those together because they are opposites. Y's are opposites now. And I get 21 plus 5 is 26x equals 0. Hey, there's nothing wrong with zeros. Don't knock it. But 0 divided by anything is still 0. So I get x equals 0. Perfectly legitimate answer. But I still need to find out what y is. So if I say 5 times 0 plus 3y is negative 6. That's the top equation. I plugged in 0 that I knew. I get 3y is negative 6 or y is negative 2. Sometimes I'm not writing down the division sign underneath. If you still need to do that, that's fine. But I'm getting to the point of saying I can see that 3 times negative 2 is negative 6. So I'm not always going to show every step painstakingly like that. But what about this equation, 7x minus y is 2? Would that be true? Well, if x was 0, 7 times 0 would be 0, minus negative 2. That's like a plus 2. 0 plus 2 is 2. Yeah, that works out, right? And over here, 5 times 0 is 0, and 3 times negative 2 is negative 6, and 0 and negative 6 is negative 6. So that's how I would check that to make sure that it's true. And one last thing here. This is the hardest kind of system to solve, so of course you'll have one of these on your final. That's how it goes. What we want to do here is we want something to be opposite, but it's not a quick fix like it was up here. We just had to multiply one equation. We're going to have to multiply both equations. Since I have the middle terms here, the y terms, negative and positive, I'm going to work on those. So what I'm interested in, what could I multiply the top equation by and the bottom equation by to make me have opposites? And I can see that 2 and 3 both go into 6. So I'm going to multiply the top equation by 2 and the bottom equation by 3. Remember, you can multiply an equation by whatever you want as long as you do it to all terms. So this is perfectly legal. 6x times 2 is 12x. 3y times 2 is 6y, but I had a minus there, so it's minus 6y. And 9 times 2 is 18. And then I have 5x times 3, which is 15x. 2y times 3 is 6y. That one was positive, and 3 times 3 is 9. And now I do have something that's going to be eliminated. Add those together, and you get 27x equals, and the y's go away, equals 27. And divide both sides by 27, and x is 1. And that is half of your answer. The other half, you're going to have to go find. So 6 times 1 minus 3y is 9. The other half of the answer is just plugging in and see. I can see 6 times 1 is 6. So I'm going to subtract 6 from both sides. 9 minus 6 is 3. And dividing both sides by negative 3, I get y is negative 1. That's what I think my answer is. I could quickly do a check. 6 times 1 is 6. Negative 3 times negative 1 is positive 3, and that equals 9. That's a 3. And then over here, 5 times 1 is 5. And 2 times negative 1 is negative 2. 5 plus negative 2 is 3. It works for both equations. A lot of times on tests or on quizzes, people miss these. And I said, did you check it? And they're like, no, because you don't want to do it. But you should be checking that because it's not that hard to do. Okay, have a fantastic day. We'll see you next time.